What's in this box? This isn't a Universal Yums box. What is this?
Well, you convinced me to bloody well open it. I hate unboxings. They're bollocks. But this is food themed, so I guess you're allowed to get away with this one this once.
What is it?
So, there's a new box company called Board Game Bento. It's definitely not a cheap box company, because obviously it's a bunch of board games. It's something... How much is it every month? You got to put it on the screen right now, because I've completely forgotten. I don't want to misrepresent them. You've edited it in on the screen right now. Aren't you a wonderful editor? Well done. Oh no, a title card. BoardGameBento.com is the place to get it. We are not sponsored by these, so I just decided to try it out. We'll see after opening this, whether or not I cancel my sub, because I just don't know if it's any good. They're supposed to send a set of themed board games every month with about a value of $85 or so. I don't know what's in it. It said food themed. There's probably a copy of Sushi Go in there, which would suck because I already have a copy of Sushi Go. But what I'm hoping is they'll find me something a little bit more interesting. Box did come a little battered, I will say.
Total biscuit with a knife.
Yeah, that's never a good idea, is it?
No, it isn't.
Well, I'm just going to get the bottom of these and try not to kill myself in the process. There we go. There. Okay, cool. All right. I like the back of the box, by the way. Three-dimensional chess. That's not canon.
Yeah.
All right. What is in the box, you might ask? All right. What do we have first? Burger bars. Burger Boss. Yes. Burger Boss. Welcome to Burger Boss, the action-filled, fun-filled world of fast food. You play the role of a promising restaurateur hoping to turn a small burger shack into the next big thing. Do you invest in workers or buy more ingredients? Okay.
No, look, turn it around.
Do you expand? I'm not done yet. Do you expand your kitchens or go for the quick sale? Do you play it safe or risk it all? Ultimately, do you have what it takes to become the Burger Boss? It's also in German. Willkommen zur Burger Boss.
No, please no.
Die Action gelad uns von Hansen, Welt des Fast Food. Sie spielen die Rolle ins Valverschrecken. Okay.
Please no.
You're claiming it has an actual burger inside.
It looked like it had one on the inside.
I think you're completely lying to me because there's
look at the side here on the inside. Do you see?
Yeah, I'm intrigued. All right, let's buy a company called Legend Express. I've never heard of them. I mean, what's cool about this box is that they might send a bunch of more obscure games that I haven't heard of, as opposed to the ones that I do know about. Which is why this might actually be worth doing. I've kind of destroyed the box in the process.
No!
Well, the problem is they decided to put tape over this, and actually cutting it without breaking the box in itself is tricky. I mean, that's fine. We found something else to store in. Jesus. Yeah. I'm opening it from the wrong side. I actually don't know what side, because they're trying to make it look like a fast food box.
Yeah.
And as a result, they made it almost impossible to open properly.
TB versus the box. Who will win? Fight.
Alright. So you got the rules. There is.
It's a burger! Look, it's a burger! Oh my gosh. Give us the burger. What is it?
So the burger was the case, I think, for the
game. Oh, that's cute.
That is kind of adorable.
It looks like a turkey burger, though, not like an actual burger, because that burger is way too light.
Yeah, so inside the burger, it's actually a multi-layered.
Oh, that's so
the dice
cute.
Is in the top. Then that's the lettuce.
And that's the lettuce.
And these are the money.
When do you ever get to say that?
The money tokens. Then you take the patty off, I guess. And inside there, that's the pack of cards that you use.
Oh, so cool.
And it's a worker placement game by the looks of it. And these are worker placement tokens right there, which I assume are probably different ingredients for the burger itself. So, neat little setup and a giant pain in the ass to reassemble. So thank you very much for that.
You put the patty on first.
Oh, God damn it. You see what I'm talking about? This is fancy, but a bloody...
Only because you don't know what you're doing.
But how is anyone supposed to learn this? Who was born with this knowledge? Well, nobody. This is something you have to learn.
But...
I've already lost the game, apparently. One of the dice has now gone out of place. The problem with making a box like this is that if you don't put everything in exactly right, it now no longer goes together anymore. It's a neat, gimmicky kind of idea for a box, but it is horribly impractical. Please don't do that again.
Next.
Yeah, so the name of that is Burger Boss. All right. Big surprise. Copy
Sushi
of Sushi Go.
Yeah.
Well, now we have two copies of Sushi Go. That's great. Sushi Go is a pick and pass card game in which you try and build the best sushi. It has a kind of adorable art, as you probably noticed. I probably should have expected them to send this because it is a food-themed box. This obviously kind of sucks because I already own it. This is the risk of owning this, of subscribing to these boxes that already have the games. But I guess I now have an extra copy of Sushi Go. All right.
Of Sushi Go,
Sushi
huh?
Go. Food Fighters, a battle game with all the right ingredients. Look, late at night, your kitchen becomes alive in a food-flinging battle to rule the tabletop. The meats march into battle against the veggies and foods fly as the factions clash. Who will emerge victorious, we ask. It contains a bunch of cards, as well as little meeples that are shaped like spoons and ingredients, which is kind of cute, I suppose. There you go. Let's see what's going on with that. I think the other thing, there's an expansion for that, but they did say that the boxes could include expansions as long as they also include the original game. Go, so there's your rule book. You have little stickers. I don't know what the purpose of those is, including bacon, a very angry chicken leg, and various other things. Bunch of cards, which have all of the actions on them as to what you can actually do. And there's the ingredient meeples, in which there are quite
little
a few.
Little spoons.
The dice actually have like beans on them and a splat tomato or whatever, and that is the other packet. And there's another. That's a piece of alive bacon. You'll never treat bacon the same again. That seems kind of neat. I'm interested to see how that one plays out. I'll certainly give it a try, no doubt.
Seems kid friendly.
Yeah, all of these are really. As far as I know, I mean, obviously Burger Boss in particular is probably the most expensive of the three games that they sent us. There is an expansion in there as well. We also have the expansion for Food Fighters, the Grains expansion. Meet the Grains faction, a whole new team of high carb warriors to add variety to your Food Fighters battle. That's an expansion for the Food Fighters game. All right. And
Gingerbread Kaiju?
Well, the box is empty. Is this like a... This is the instructions for a game that isn't in the box, by the looks of it.
Okay.
Oh. Oh.
Oh?
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. It's not in the box because you literally have to bake it. These are the instructions to bake the ingredients for the Gingerbread Kaiju game.
Oh my gosh, it's so cute.
Yeah, these are the ingredients for the various pieces. Is it? I don't know, actually. No, I don't think that's true. So these are ingredients that go along from the geekyhostess.com.
Oh, go along with it.
Yeah.
Oh.
So
there's still no...
There's no... unless it's...
Is it a cutout?
No, you literally do have to bake it.
Oh,
no,
okay.
I actually was right the first time. This has the ingredients. This is a board game in which you have to bake the pieces.
And it says eat your enemies, so I'm assuming that yes. As some
yeah, and there's rules for governing
edible.
Like how many parts it has. And then you, yeah, that's...
If you really fail at baking, this could be a really fun game.
It's an interesting idea. Like, it's also a very cheap way of putting another game in the box without having to barely pay for anything, which I think is a little bit of a cop-out by the people that made this. But, yeah, these are instructions on how to make all of the kaiju and the different, like, shapes to use, and that's what they're supposed to look like.
It's like if you suck at gingerbread house building, then this one is probably not for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, and these are rules on how to do it.
Cool.
Yeah, in order to play it, you will need one kaiju per player, decorative icing, a deck of standard playing cards, one or more D12s, which they don't include with this, which is a bit of a cop-out, assorted candies, cookies, and baking goods. You can replace them with inedible markers and stuff, but yeah, it's a rule book, and then you have to bake the ingredients. Then again, it comes along with all of these
you
little...
You have to bake the ingredients to make
it's
the kaiju.
It's a cute idea, but it's also like, wow, how can we not include another one? So, yeah, those are the...
Probably offsetting how expensive Burger Boss was, I guess.
I guess Burger Boss is probably the most expensive of them.
Yeah,
I don't think there's any doubt about that. I mean, Sushi Go is about a $12 game. I know that because I bought it. I don't know about the Food Fighters game. Apparently, the Burger Boss includes a exclusive order card called Settlers of Kitchan, which I thought was kind of neat. Yeah, and that's exclusive to the board game Bento. If I didn't already own Sushi Go, I'd definitely say that that is a... probably a pretty cool box. I mean, Sushi Go is great. Admittedly, Sushi Go is also $12, not like the $45 or whatever this box costs. I mean, with Burger Boss included in Food Fighters, that's pretty good. As I say, I think the inclusion of Gingerbread Kaiju is a bit of a cop-out because it literally is just a rule book. I mean, you could just get this as a PDF. So that's not ideal. It's a cool themed box, though. I mean, you know, I thought they were going to do Sushi Go. I think that's because it's an obvious choice. But the inclusion of something like neat, like, you know, this is kind of cool, I guess. I think I'll have to see what the next ones are like. It's obviously, you can't really do a huge margin on stuff like this. Game, you know, stuff like Loot Crate is just a box of plastic crap, which, you know, they generally get from conventions and such. This is actual, like, real board games they have to pay for, so then you're not going to get, like, a super great value on it, I don't think. And I think the risk for people that already own board games like me is that you might already have a copy of one of the games, at which point the value proposition goes out the window. Because, like, oh, well, one of the games that kind of made this good value I already own, so now I might as well have just bought this game. But the nice thing about it is that it does curate it by theme, which I think is kind of neat, and it lets you, it's kind of a discovery method to discover new games that you wouldn't, I mean, I've never heard of this before, you know, so it's cool to do that. And as much as this is a cop-out, it's a neat idea, and Food Fighters looks like it might be pretty cool too. So I'm not convinced on the value for money as of yet. That is definitely one of the more expensive monthly boxes. I'll give it another shot and see what they have next month, and obviously try these games out in the process. But I think the problem they have is their market is kind of people that are already into board games, and then those people have to risk getting a duplicate, which obviously is of no use. Obviously, you can sell it on eBay if you want, but this is, you know, this game's almost worthless. There's so many copies of it around. It's not like it's rare or anything. So, neat, you know, cool little theme. Not entirely convinced as to whether or not it's worth subscribing to yet, but I guess we'll find out. There you go. That's an unboxing, I guess. It's food themed, you know, whatever. I guess it fits in. I don't like doing these. It's pointless. Why do you even watch this?